加拿大华人社团联席会举行反仇视亚裔活动图片及视频展。最近几年，针对亚裔的种族歧视和暴力袭击事件在加拿大频繁发生，尤其是自去年以来，仅在温哥华的案发率就增加了7倍，引起亚裔人士的恐慌和社会各界的关注。从2021年3月开始，各地举行了多次游行示威，人们奔走呼吁停止仇视亚裔。加拿大华人社团联席会也在第一时间积极行动起来，分别在温哥华、本拿比、列治文举行了众多社团参与的烛光悼念因歧视和种族暴力逝去的生命示威活动。联席会一些成员和所属社团还参加了加拿大全国多个城市同时举行的停止仇视亚裔的行动，并给警察局、市政府、省政府写信，发出了依法对仇视亚裔的行为进行治罪的呼吁。今天，加拿大华人社团联席会在线举行《华裔对加拿大之贡献》及反暴力、反歧视亚裔图片和视频回放，以唤醒大众对此事的认知，鼓励大家积极发声，维护自身权益，维护加拿大多元文化价值观。在反对仇视亚裔的漫漫长路上，让我们一起携手前行。
大家好，我是加拿大华人社团联席会执行主席魏仁民。今天我们一起纪念 BC 省设立反种族歧视觉醒周，这是保护亚裔社区的一个开始，为加拿大的多元文化交流，为加拿大的社会发展，我们每个社团每一个人都是不可或缺的一部分。弘扬华裔对加拿大多元文化之贡献，反歧视亚裔，反暴力，这就是我们一致的主张。加拿大华人社团联席会自成立以来，致力于专注服务社区，积极争取和维护包括华人在内的各族裔人民的平等权益，致力于各族裔人民平等相待，和谐共处。针对亚裔仇视事件，联席会组织和我们共同的各个社团，我们已经觉醒，将积极行动起来，配合各地亚裔社团组织大规模的抗议示威活动，并在社交群体上动员更多的人们参与，一起来捍卫所有的人的平等的权利。最后感谢 BC 省市议员以及各参加活动的所有的亚裔社会的精英们和侨领们，我们的团结一致将是为社区服务做出贡献的根本保障，谢谢大家。
尊敬的各位来宾、各位朋友，大家好，我是曲哲斌 Teresa Ward。首先感谢主办方，感谢各社区团体、社区领袖和热心的人士，为了社区和谐与族裔平等而举办的这次华裔对加拿大多元文化之贡献反歧视亚裔反暴力图片视频回放活动。我也非常高兴地看到基于 BC 交通和我提倡的反种族主义教育日而来的反种族主义醒觉周得以确立，而且在此期间将会举办多场各种形式的教育活动，其目的是愿全体社会向种族主义说不，大家站着一起抗拒任何形式的种族主义，共同打造一个更加美好和更加包容的 BC 省。 一直以来，我都是非常关注族裔平等，消除种族歧视。我在前 BC 州党政府出任多元文化厅长的期间，推动省议会为早期排华政策向华裔加拿大人正式道歉，并协助落实一系列的后续工作，包括推行华人全情计划，在本省重要的华人历史遗址立碑纪念先朝的贡献，把华裔加拿大人在本地的历史写入教科书，以及重新检视本省超过2000条法案，永久移除所有带有歧视内容的法规。特别在最近，针对歧视亚裔事件的频繁发生，我在3月底出席了温哥华艺术馆外举行的反歧视亚裔集会，并开启倡议确立反种族主义照入日，开展网上签名活动，以寻求支持并获得政府关注和重视。时间已经过去两个月，期间社会公众对种族主义歧视及仇恨等议题的持续关注，让我更加坚定了我的想法，积极推动省府长期而且持续的开展反歧视教育的活动，并作出改变。我想感谢在这期间来自11000多位 BC 省民和加拿大人、170多个不同族裔社区和文化团体的支持，感谢大家签名支持由我发起的反种族主义教育日的网上签名请愿活动。现在省政府吸取 BC 教党的反种族主义教育日的提议及相关的建议，设立着这种教育的反种族主义省哲州。今天我们华裔社区也积极行动起来了，举办这样一场宣传和教育的公开活动，我感到非常高兴和欣慰，因为教育始终是对抗无知及仇恨的最有效的工具，它让省民有机会学习如何识别、挑战、预防及消除仇恨，从而纠正省内引进种族主义的价值观、架构、政策、计划、习惯和行为。只有这样，才能有效地减少歧视行为的发生。同时，我也在这里呼吁，希望省政府让种族主义省哲州成为传统，不但在今年，之后每年都举办相关的教育活动，让我们一起来消除任何形式的种族主义和不包容。最后，我祝雾的活动取得圆满成功，并再次感谢各位的关注与支持。愿我们每个人都能在一个平等和有和谐的社会中幸福生活。谢谢大家。
Hi everyone, my name is Anne Kang, MLA for Burnaby Deer Lake and Minister of Advanced Education and Skills Training. 大家好，我是康安里，本拿比鹿湖区省议员以及高等教育技术及培训厅长。I'm sending you this message from the traditional and unceded territory of the Musqueam, Squamish and Tsleil-Waututh peoples. As an immigrant to this beautiful land, I often reflect on how lucky I am to be able to live and work in BC. Thank you for Canadian Alliance of Chinese Associations for inviting me to speak with you in this important event about anti-Asian racism. Hate has no place in BC. The pandemic has been challenging for all of us this past year, but particularly for racialized communities who have been impacted by a rise in incidents of racism and hate. Throughout the pandemic, we've seen different communities targeted by hate crimes, particularly Asian communities and Indigenous peoples. Just Burnaby alone has seen 350% increase of anti-Asian hate crimes cases in 2020. Last month in April, I experienced firsthand, right outside my office, someone was shouting xenophobic comments about how Asian women didn't belong in government and that I ought to be sent back to China. I know that many people have experienced racialized violence and hate crimes far worse than this. These kinds of incidents happen far more often than some might believe, but they're often not reported or talked about because of the very real concerns about their personal safety. Because of the voices and advocacy of many people, including Canadian Alliance of Chinese Associations, our government has proclaimed May 23rd to 29th to be Anti-Racism Awareness Week in BC. Diversity is what makes our BC community beautiful and resilient. Let's use this week to celebrate our cultures and reflect on our personal contributions to society. We should truly appreciate the beauty of the artistic and cultural diversity that Asian Canadian community bring to Canadian society. And let's put our passion into action. We must all stand up against racist words and actions and speak out against hate when we see it. Together, we can build an anti-racist BC. Thank you for your solidarity.
Hello, 大家好，我是 Katrina Chen 陈伟珍，卑诗省省务厅长跟 Burnaby Lougheed 的省议员。卑诗省是个非常多元文化的省份，但很可惜，近期种族歧视问题却逐渐增长。省政府在近年也一直针对种族歧视做出许多的投资跟行动，所以我们决定在5月23到30号这礼拜宣布为反种族主义宣传周 Anti-Racism Awareness Week， 强调我们一定要用行动来继续打击种族歧视，包括省政府提供资源跟经费支持本地组织反种族歧视活动，设立新的种族歧视举报热线，透过我们的学校来教育和支持多元文化和反歧视的重要性，还有省政府准备为反种族歧视所推出的历史性法案。我们每一个人都有责任来一起反歧视，希望大家都能够在这礼拜花些时间想想我们自身可能会有的偏见跟盲点，勇于指出问题跟不当的言论。我们每个人都需要尽一己之力来为我们的社会、家庭跟孩子创造更包容、美好跟平等的未来。谢谢。
大家好，我是李耀华，温哥华兰加尔省区省议员。感谢加拿大华人宣传联席会。Hello, I'm Michael Lee, the MLA for Vancouver Langara. Thank you to the Canadian Alliance of Chinese Associations for organizing this very important event and for inviting me to speak. British Columbia has regrettably had a history of racism.The impacts of which can still be seen and felt today. Even with the progress and changes we've made, racism still exists in our society, and I know that we are committed to combating all forms of racism together. Over the past year, we've seen a stark increase in hate crimes and overt acts of racism in our province. The rise in racism over the last year has also come in the form of anti-Asian hate in British Columbia, with the Vancouver Police Department reporting a staggering 717% increase in anti-Asian hate crime incidents in 2020. Acts of violence in the form of verbal and physical assaults and other hate crimes have all increased dramatically since the beginning of the COVID-19 pandemic. Our province and our country have a history of racism towards people of Asian descent, and I've seen evidence of it over the course of my own life. In the late 1980s,I worked as a volunteer in Vancouver's Chinatown with the Human Rights Committee of the Chinese Benevolent Association of Vancouver, interviewing payees and their families of the Head Pact, which had been a measure to discourage Chinese immigration in the day. This tax culminated in the Chinese Exclusion Act of 1923, which banned nearly all Chinese immigration to Canada for years, separating many families. The Exclusion Act was repealed in 1947, just 6 years before my father came to BC from Hong Kong in 1953. And for another 20 years after that, until 1967, immigration restrictions on the basis of race and national origin were still not erased. This period demonstrates the importance of education in our fight against racism, in realizing that we are not that far removed from the darker parts of our history. But let us not be discouraged, but instead embolden to push us forward to make real and lasting change for the benefit of everyone, including our families and children in our province. We must continue to be vigilant in addressing any bias and racism in our institutions and in our communities, and find ways to foster greater empathy towards others. We also need to be united in our work towards building a more inclusive society in British Columbia and not stoke division between communities. Let us all be strong and firm in standing up against racism. Thank you. 谢谢大家。
大家好，我是本大理事市议员黄白静。加拿大华人社团联席会在5月29号通过线上举办华裔对加拿大多元化之贡献、反歧视亚裔、反暴力的照片和视频回放活动。这个活动是非常的有意义。自疫情爆发以来，针对亚裔的种族歧视的行为和暴力事件是愈演愈烈，各级政府和社团都表达了强烈的反对的立场。加拿大华人社团联席会联合本地各社团，在大温各个城市，包括本大比市，举办了反亚裔种族歧视、反暴力的抗议活动。我也在本大比参与了这个活动，活动引起了社会的强烈的反响。各级政府也通过各种方式表达针对亚裔的种族歧视的行为的反对的严正的立场。本大比市在去年5月份通过动议表达了反对针对亚裔的种族歧视的行为的这样的一个立场，这也是大温地区第一个城市通过动议来表达这样的一个鲜明的立场。不久前，本大比市率先将5月10号确定为反亚裔种族歧视的行动日，这个活动得到了全国10多个城市的热烈的反响和响应，他们也将5月10号一起确定为反亚裔种族歧视的行动日。我们相信通过大家一起的努力，一定可以将反亚裔种族歧视的这个活动我们持续下去，我们一起来构建一个更多元化、更和谐的这样一个社会。所以我衷心的祝愿这个活动取得圆满成功，谢谢大家。
Thank you. There are more than 1,000 self-reported instances of anti-Asian racism nationwide since the start of pandemic, and there are 44% happened in BC. It is so disheartening to see these numbers. This is not solely a pandemic-related phenomena. This is systemic racism that we have to address. As an Asian Canadian, although I was not born in this beautiful country, but this is my home. We need many more Canadians to stand with the Asian Canadians to stop the hate, to make Canada truly an inclusive country for all. Please speak up when you see racism. Please do not ignore it when you see racism. We can do better by stopping it altogether. This month is also the Asian Heritage Month, where there will be so many opportunities for you to learn the cultures, languages, and arts.Let's all stop the hate. Thank you.
我们亚裔受到的伤害是加拿大多元文化的悲哀。加拿大的主要政党应该看见，我们亚裔受到了越来越多的伤害。主要政党要为我们生存权利负起责任。加拿大政党、主流社会要为亚裔社区增加安全感。增加我们的安全感而做出努力。亚洲社区人士在加拿大、美国和各个领域一直充当着良好公民的形象。
是由中华会馆及华人社团联席会合办集会，烛光悼念亚人或者亚洲人在北美洲受到很不公平的歧视。我亦都同一时间向在 Atlanta City 被杀害的亚洲人悼念他们。
人多次成为代罪的羔羊，美国和加拿大每当经济下滑，部分的政客把经济不景和那些责任推在中国人的手上。2020年3月，特朗普政府公开放话中国病毒。
11日，全美各地爆发示威游行。3月21日，加拿大蒙特利尔也爆发了一场反亚裔歧视游行，人们一路游行抗议亚裔在疫情间所受到的歧视。
如果受到了这种歧视，受到这种伤害，必须要发出声音，让社会来关注，大家要团结起来。
加拿大华人社团联席会声明，反歧视亚裔必须立法，停止仇视亚裔成为北美社交媒体热搜的关键词。
那么好的一个国家，如果说遭到歧视门都不敢出的话，我觉得我们都应该发声了。我们虽然是亚裔，可我们不是亚裔。
要突破我们的抗议行动，督推政府和加拿大议会推出反歧视亚裔法案，从法律上和制度上确保我们的权益，从根本上杜绝种族歧视的言论和行动。
每当经济下滑的时候，部分的政客就把这个经济的责任推在中国人身上。
那我们今天在这里大声的呼喊，反对暴力事件，反对歧视，反对针对亚裔的暴力袭击案件，要为我们的未来创造一个更好更健康的人文环境。
如果我们未来我们遇到什么，我们看到什么，无论如何我们一定要出声，我们要一定要发声，所以站出来为我们华裔社区呢做一点事情。
No more hate! Stop Asian hate! No more hate! Stop Asian hate!
Family, it doesn't matter how we look.
Cherish your Asian brothers and sisters, just like one of your own. Love your Asian brothers and sisters, just like one of your own. No more hate! Stop Asian hate! No more hate! Stop Asian hate!
Cherish your Asian brothers and sisters, just like one of your own. Love your Asian brothers and sisters, just like one of your own.
No more hate! No more hate! Stop Asian hate! No more hate! Stop Asian hate!
Branches in the wild, I built railroads through the unknown. Cherish your Asian brothers and sisters, just like one of your own. Love your Asian brothers and sisters, just like one of your own. Somewhere over the rainbow is a place we all call home. You send the rockets to the moon. I built home.
We have never been a loud people. Our elders always taught us that actions speak louder than words, so we learn to keep our heads down, keep our grades up, keep our kin close, keep our mouth shut. I wonder what it does to a people when they stay quiet for so long. Do they forget their voice? The sound of their stories, the resilience of language? When you are no longer in your motherland, does your mother tongue still sing of home? What work songs lifted our spirits as we built the railroad? What prayers did we whisper as they sent us to camps in the mountains to meditate on all the ways we don't belong to this country? So we stayed quiet. As they burned our Chinatowns down and spit on our grandmas at bus stops, we stayed quiet. As they laughed in our faces and told us to go back where we came from, but they've mistaken our silence for compliance. Looked on our meekness as weakness. See, we, and not the submissive stereotype that's been depicted on silence, on us, they've gotten it twisted. See, silence is golden, as are we. A gradient of yellow to brown, every Koreatown, a little Saigon, an act of defiance. Every hunchbacked elder, a humble giant. Silence is grace in the triumph, is peace in the riot. Silence is bold, a force. It is the brewing calm before the coming storm, and now the sky is splitting open and the rage is pouring forth, so this is for every kid who has ever tried to pull their nose bridge to make it taller. Every time they mocked us because our eyes are smaller, this is for our elders both alive and remembered, for their lessons, the tough and the tender. For our full names, past and present, may they be pronounced, may they be respected. For every chink in the national fabric, every nip in the winter wind of prairie towns and northern hamlets coast to coast on stolen land, we are here. We've been here. From takeout joints and internment camps to internships and graduation caps, we are strong. We have pride. We fight. We fall. We rise. And to the ones who say we don't belong, it's them who should open their eyes.
If there comes a day when you like me, if you're also mistreated and cursed, what will you think? What will you do? You feel hopeless and depressed. If there comes a day when you like me. If your mess honest to them bully, what will you think? What will you do?